I've had a great interest in medical education and in education of surgical residents to become competent, and the Royal College has taken the lead in developing processes in order to change the way that we train residents by measuring competency as opposed to just knowledge. Like, it's one thing to know how to do an aortic valve replacement, but it's another thing altogether to prove that you can actually do it from start to finish. We embraced this as a specialty early on, and we've now got our first residents across the country that are doing competency-based training. And I was asked to come speak to my cardiology colleagues, because I'm the chair of the Royal College Committee in Cardiac Surgery, to give an overview of our experience and give them a heads up the obstacles that they're going to face and what they're going to have to really change in terms of their processes in order to make this successful. Because training people with competency requires a lot of engagement. You got to embrace change and figure out the processes to get everybody on board. Well, one of the things is to change the people's perceptions. People look at training and they say, it was good enough for me, why do we have to change? The second thing is you got to get people to understand that it's going to be necessary to coach our trainees as opposed to just doing what's called a formative assessment at the end of a period of time. Every single day is going to be like a tennis coach. And the resident's done a procedure, or they've seen a patient and assessed a patient, and then you're going to give them feedback right then and there, as opposed to waiting a month later on. And so it's a whole new philosophy that we're now becoming coaches as opposed to educators that fill in a report card at the end of the 3-month period. Everyone's doing it pretty quickly, and it takes about two years of developing the EPAs, and we did that as a committee in cardiac surgery, and cardiology is just finishing that, so that there's all these entrustable professional activities that have been developed that define what a cardiologist is, and then they will implement it starting probably July 1st next year, where their first trainees will be admitted to cardiology programs that will be under the EPA process.